Hi, I'm Susan Taylor with Scripps Health in San Diego, California. Heart failure is a life-threatening condition that affects more than 5 million people each year in the United States. Joining us to talk about heart failure is cardiologist and heart failure specialist, Dr. Ajay Srivastava with Scripps Clinic in La Jolla, California. Doctor, thanks so much for being with us.
Thank you, Susan. It's a pleasure.
What happens when the heart starts to fail?
Let me try to explain heart failure by showing this model over here. The heart has two upper chambers and two lower chambers. And when we say heart failure, we're typically referring to the left main squeezing chamber of the heart. And it means that either the heart's not squeezing well enough or not relaxing well enough. And if the heart doesn't squeeze well enough, we don't have enough blood flow getting to the body. And if it squeezes well and it's stiff and does not relax well, then fluid builds up in the lungs. So typically when we say someone has heart failure, we're referring to either they're not getting enough blood flow or fluid is backing up into their lungs and the rest of the body.
But heart failure does not mean that the heart has completely stopped, right?
That is correct. When we say heart failure, it's quite a spectrum. You could have really mild heart failure, and you could have heart failure to the other extreme where you need a heart pump or a heart transplant. And when we see patients referred to us for heart failure, we determine where in the spectrum of heart failure is a given patient and determine what the course of action should be for a given patient.
So heart failure is different though than a heart attack, correct?
That's correct. Heart failure refers to when the heart muscle is not squeezing well or it's stiff. Heart attack refers to when there's a blockage in one of the main arteries supplying blood flow to the heart.
And what are the symptoms of heart failure?
So symptoms of heart failure usually are fatigue, difficulty breathing, tiredness, sudden weight gain, ankle swelling. Those are the most common symptoms of heart failure.
And there are different types of heart failure. Can you explain what systolic heart failure is versus diastolic heart failure?
Absolutely. When we say systolic heart failure, we're referring to the pumping function of the heart. It's not squeezing well enough. When we say diastolic heart failure, we mean the heart muscle is stiff and not relaxing well. And we refer to that as diastolic heart failure.
So what causes heart failure?
The heart failure typically occurs because of one, if patients have had a heart attack, a large heart attack and a big blockage that affected blood flow to the heart. But the other common reasons for heart failure are high blood pressure, high blood sugar, diabetes, certain lifestyle choices like smoking, being overweight. So those are other common reasons for heart failure.
And is there a genetic component to heart failure? Let's say that your parents or your grandparents had it. Does that make you more at risk for having heart failure?
There's certainly some conditions or gene mutations that run in the families, and that could predispose a patient to getting heart failure. And there's certain other times where you could have the mutation but not develop heart failure. And we work with the patient and do their genetic testing to see if they have just a mutation or have mutation leading to heart failure.
And heart failure can actually exist for years before you really start showing any symptoms?
That's correct. Symptoms of heart failure can exist for a while before the patient goes sees a doctor, because they could be a little short of breath. They could notice I've gained a couple of pounds, and they might just attribute that to, oh, I'm getting a little older, and might not think much of it. So yes, symptoms of heart failure can be there for a while before a patient sees the physician.
When should you go see a cardiologist versus when should you go to the emergency room?
Yeah, I think if the symptoms come on suddenly, like if you have sudden shortness of breath, sudden chest pain, you're dizzy, lightheaded, those are times you don't want to wait. You just want to go to the emergency room for further evaluation. If the same symptoms came on more gradually, over time you've noticed your breathing is being affected, you're a little bit more tired, those are times when you say, okay, I'm going to make an appointment with a primary care physician or a cardiologist for further investigation.
So doctor, how do you diagnose heart failure? What are the tests?
So the first test we do when we suspect heart failure, we start with an EKG or an electrocardiogram to look at your heart rate and heart rhythm. And then we follow that up with what we call as an echocardiogram or an ultrasound of your heart muscle to see how it's squeezing and how it's relaxing, and also looking at the valves along with the heart muscle.
So how do you treat heart failure?
So I advise all my patients to start with lifestyle changes. You want to get a good diet, watch the amount of sodium, watch the liquids, stay away from soda and tobacco and those bad habits. But try to get at least 20 minutes of physical activity most days of the week. Some of my patients like running, some patients like swimming, but anything that's fun and you enjoy, try to do at least 20 minutes on most days. If I do that and then medications and my patient comes back to me still with symptoms, we are fortunate at Scripps to have many devices and therapies that as a heart team, we can offer to our patients. One of which is this device here. This is called the CardioMEMS device. And it's a chip that we place between the heart and the lungs. And it's an outpatient procedure. And with this chip-like device, patients can stay at home and I can real-time monitor their fluid levels. So this is a great option for our patients and it offers them the comfort of staying at home and us still being able to take care of them real-time. Now, if they still have other conditions or symptoms beyond fluid management, we have a couple more options and I wanted to show that with the heart model over here. If they have a valve problem, we work with the heart team and we can offer them a valve procedure, in some cases open heart surgery, but in many cases without having to do open heart surgery, just by a stent-like procedure, we can put a valve in here that reduces the amount of leakage. And this is great for patients who have heart failure. It really helps them feel a lot better. Now, if they have weakness of the heart muscle, then we can put a heart pump in over here, and that heart pump takes over the work of the heart muscle. And this is just an example or a couple of examples of treatment options that we have for our patients with heart failure.
The technology is just incredible. Any final thoughts, doctor?
So advice to all patients with heart disease, high blood pressure, or worried about getting heart failure, my advice would be to follow basic healthy principles, which is diet, physical activity, and sleep. With diet, you want to do things in moderation, stay away from excessive salt, excessive sugars, try to avoid processed food as much as possible, and eat a clean, healthy diet for the most part. With activity, try to get at least 20 minutes most days of the week, something you like to do, whether it's swimming, running, jogging, but get out there, have fun, and be active. And the third, and maybe the most ignored part of good health is sleep. Try to get 6 to 8 hours of good sleep. And I think that's my advice to patients with heart disease or want to do the best they can to prevent heart disease or heart failure. But should you have any symptoms or you've been diagnosed with this condition, we can help you at Scripps. We have an excellent heart team and can offer therapies that can help you live a good life.
Doctor, thanks so much for being with us. We really appreciate you taking the time.
Thank you, Susan. And it was a pleasure and look forward to helping patients with heart failure.
Thanks again. Scripps is consistently ranked by U.S. News and World Report as having one of the best cardiology and heart surgery programs in the United States. Want more information on heart failure? Just click on the link or go to scripps.org/videos. Want more critical information about your health? Please subscribe to our Scripps Health YouTube channel and follow us on social media at Scripps Health. At Scripps, we're here for good. I'm Susan Taylor. Thanks for joining us.